Thank you, Arun. Great pleasure seeing Venkat again. We've known each other for at least 40 years, and ideologically, we have been on the same side. And when it was unpopular to be on that side, we were together. And then now, of course, it's become the mainstream ideology of India, too. So we are celebrating. But there was one issue which Jagdish, myself, and Ramesh, we have been discussing. In India, at least, people are afraid of the law and the law enforcement. They just don't know what their liabilities are. They don't know simple things, whether a policeman can come anytime to your house and arrest you and take you away, or there are some formalities that have to be filled before you can be obliged to accompany him to the police station. Whether women can be arrested after 6 p.m. in the evening. So many things which, when I go around in, at dinner time, I explain the law. People are amazed that how come we didn't know all this. It's because in schools and all, they don't teach. So our job is now primarily through this Virat Hindustan Sangam, which is purely educational institution in the sense that we are trying to create a new mindset of the Indian people, a self-confidence in the democracy of our India, of our country. So what I've come here basically to listen to Venkat, who's always a great pleasure to listen to him because of his analytical mind. I just want him to give, first of all, and these are going to be many lectures over the next few weeks. What is a constitution? Two, what are fundamental rights? Is it true that since I have a fundamental right to speak, therefore I can say anything? Or are there reasonable restrictions on it? If so, where can I find those reasonable restrictions? What are some other well-known reasonable restrictions? And then third on to the Indian Penal Code, which are the laws for what, and how does one initiate the law? Supposing there is a crime committed, can you, as an individual citizen, initiate it? If so, under what clause of the Constitution, under what section of the Constitution, and how do you proceed? How is it that I, people ask me, without a law degree, I am everywhere and arguing as I please? And does it mean that you don't need a law degree? So, what do you need to know to be able to argue in court? What are the court rights? So, there's a series of things. So, we'd like to go step by step. And I would suggest that your Venkat, your Dr. Venkat, I should say, Venkat, you are free to say in what manner, what sequence. I'm only suggesting to you, first, please clear the minds of all of us on what is a constitution and what does it contain.